when you think about what you want in an earthquake, think about what life is like and how to stay in your home. We are not going to have predictions. It's not so much that go bag idea. You probably are staying in your home or at least your backyard. So what are the supplies you need? The first is water. Second is water, third is water. The rest of it all comes somewhere after that. Because you can't live without water for more than a couple of days. Our water pipes are some of the most vulnerable parts of our infrastructure. The pipe going into your house might very well break. However much water you're storing, get some more. You probably don't have enough. In addition to that, you're probably not having power. So ways to keep your phone charged is the newest preparedness measure that is really important. Access to a radio. You know, if you have a car, you've probably got an AM radio. You can just turn on the engine there and get it that way. When you're looking at children, in the week after an earthquake, you're not going to endanger their health by having less than perfectly healthy food. But you're going to have some very stressed out kids. So yeah, you don't feed them Tootsie Roll Pops every day, but right after the earthquake, it might be a wonderful thing to have. Last thing I'd say, that have some cash. When you don't have electricity, when the business that you're going to doesn't have internet, you can't use your credit card. And a bit of cash could make all the difference in the world.